I was born in Nuremberg in Germany on the 23rd of February 1924. I was called Heinz Wuga. I'm an only child. I had a normal upbringing with my parents. We went into the country at weekends. I went to the local school, which was perfectly good, until the Nazis came to power. And even before, in Nuremberg, even before the Nuremberg laws, the anti-Semitism was horrendous. I mean, sitting in school, people would sing anti-Semitic songs. And when I think you had half the class were your friends, some people were your friends, all of a sudden, nobody spoke to you, neither the teachers nor your friends, because of that pressure of the Nazis, have nothing to do with Jews. The children were intimidated, their parents might lose their job or advancement, and it was really horrendous. It's quite shocking, but they were singing a ditty. I'll do it in German first and then in English. Zwei Juden baden in einem Fluss, weil sich ne Sau mal waschen muss. Der eine ist ersoffen, vom anderen wollen wir es hoffen. Two Jews bathe in a water hollow, because even a pig has to clean itself. One quickly drowned, we hope the other one will follow. I mean, you're sitting there, 10 years of age, and they're singing this into your face, so we knew this. This is no good.
I was born in Berlin, Germany, on the 23rd of March, 1925. My name was Rosa Mary Goldschall. When we moved to Hermsdorf, which is part of Berlin itself, but not in the center of Berlin, I went to school there, and at the first intake there, it was a happy school. I mean, I was very small. The teacher thought I was a little Prümelchen, which was a little flower, and they were very sweet. And then I moved to Hermsdorf, went to school there, and we had a lovely teacher, and was very good, very kind, and very patient. Until one day, we went outside and we went into the forest. There was a forest very close to us. And we were all singing songs, we were happy. And a woman's voice shouted, "Can you not be respectful? President Hindenburg has died." We didn't know. So of course we had to go back, leave the forest and go back. And that was, in fact, the starting point when Hindenburg died and Hitler came to power. The whole situation changed. What was interesting was because when Hindenburg died, there had been a holiday. And then when we went back to school, the Nazi flag, the Hakenkreuz, was, of course, there. We were in the school playground. We were all standing to attention, and the Nazi flag was hoisted. We were shown how to make the Nazi salute and to raise our arms and say, "Heil Hitler." What was interesting to us, just before the ceremony, the door opened and the school janitor was taken out on a barrow. He evidently had been killed. He, I was told, had been a communist. And at that time, there was a lot of tension there, basically between the communists and the National Socialists. We went, following that ceremony, we were asked to go back to the classroom, and this teacher I had, Frau Schmidt, a lovely person. And she stood in front of the class and she said, as long as I am teacher here, no Jewish child will be hurt. And she was really a tremendous person, not only a good teacher, but a good human being, and very caring. The teacher we used to have was very kind. But one day, we were asked to come to school in the evening, and it was winter time, and we were given a lesson of the stars. And she said, children, do you see the stars in the sky? And she gave us the names of some of the stars and then came to one star. And she said, do you see that star up there? That is the Judenstern.
The Jewish star.
The Jewish star. And all the children in the class turned round, not in the class, but was outside, turned and looked at the four of us, or three of us, who were Jewish. It was actually very difficult. I mean, we were quite young at the time, after all, and you suddenly were exposed to such nastiness, and it was really quite stupid, too. But I always felt that she felt embarrassed by saying that. But what was she to do? She was, after all, watched and listened to. And if she didn't carry out what the Nazis wanted, she would have lost her job. So I think one has to look at it from that point of view. So there were a number of things. One of the other things I was very, very conscious of, and it was very hurtful. I was good at music. We used to have music dictation. I was, after all, quite young, as I said, about 7, then 8 years old, and always got it correct. I was always accused of cheating. That idiot of a man couldn't even call me by my first name, Der Goldschall. Der Goldschall hat geschummelt, or she had cheated. I mean, the stupidity of it, that is what happened every time.